Hello, in this video we will use the Echo Structure Machine Expert software. At first we want to open a new project. In this case we are using a project from example. Select the robotic module example. It shows you a complete structure of a Cartesian robot with three axes for a pack drive tree controller. Adapt the project name and the location. If necessary, you can update the devices and libraries. Now have a look at the device tree structures. In this Circus Masters are all relevant drives and the power supply prepared and parametricized for a Cartesian robot. In the visualized stream there are some layers. The machine layer includes a program that controls in the submodules action equipment modules. In this project, the equipment module is a program of a robot. The robot module program includes in the submodules actions a function block of the robot. All configurations of the robot have to be defined in the init robot action. Therefore, we open it now. This standard interface is needed to set up your robot. This implementation is necessary for each robot type. Now we need to configure a Schneider robot some additional libraries. One is the Schneider Electric Robotics parameters, and the other one is the Schneider Electric Robotics library. The ST robot interface contains all the module specific parameters and return values for the FB robot module. To avoid that the interface is empty, there is an IF condition implemented. Here you can see the implementation of your robot kinematic. In this case, a Cartesian 3-axis robot is implemented. Now we have to change and add some code to configure a P4 Delta robot successfully. Here is an overview of the type codes of the Delta robots. For example, we will choose a robot type P4 with a rotational axis. The chosen type code we now use here. If the output X rotational axis required is true, there's a following initialization of the auxiliary axis executed. To configure a Schneider robot, you have to call an additional Schneider Electric configuration method. All the robot axes have to be assigned to the listed Circus Master drives. To modify the coordinate system of the Schneider robot correctly, you need an additional method, getCoordinateSystem. Because an internal calculation is done in the function block of the P-series robot. This auxiliary axis is not used anymore because of the call before. The next step is to configure parameters in case of an emergency stop. Now the configuration is done and we have to call the config_done method. In the next if condition is ensure that the config_done was successful, if not the controller should throw an exception. In the end all drives have to be initialized and the manual mode too. In case of a real access, you have to do some changes at the drive's parameters. Here's an overview of the drive parameter changes of each robot type. We have to use the first row. At least we have to adapt the parameters of the drives, example the gear ratio and the user max peak current. All changes have to be done in the drive A, B, C and auxiliary axis at the Circus Master. change user drive P current to value 7500 for ABC drive. Change gear in, gear out to value 2 and 77 for ABC drive. Change the direction in ABC. Change, if required, the feed constant to value 360 for ABC drive. Change apps encoder offset to value 500 for ABC drive. Do the same for the auxiliary axis. See therefore the overview again. After all these steps, a P4 Delta robot is configured.